My name's Melissa. This is my stepdaughter, Corey, and we're from Woodbridge, New Jersey.
I'm here for a private reading with Teresa in hopes to talk to my mother.
Come in!
Since my mom passed, I've had a hard time opening up to people just because, like, I didn't want her to feel like I'd be forgetting about her.
Nice to meet you, Melissa.
Nice to meet you, Melissa. Come on in.
Corey.
You must be Corey. Nice to meet you, you pretty little thing. Nice to meet you. Come on in.
I'm hoping that the reading today gives her the peace and closure to let more people in and just be happy.
This has to do with you knowing that your loved ones are still with you and that they're safe and at peace. So, now, there's a mother energy here.
When my mother died, I didn't really comprehend it. I was just, like, in such shock. She was everything to me.
How are you connected to her?
Stepmother.
Okay. Did you write something in memory of your mom?
Yeah, I did.
Because she just said to me, please tell her that she is my hero.
In computer class, we did a project, and it was on someone that's your hero, and I did it on my mom.
Did you just hear what she said?
When you walked in, I heard that if she says or talks about the necklace, then I will know that it is my mom.
Oh, my God.
I did say that. I said that. I put a necklace in my mom's coffin, and no one knew that, but Teresa did, so it's crazy.
How do you connect with the number one?
The day she passed. Corey's mother, Arlie, passed away 4 years ago after being hit by a car. Corey went to bed that night and never saw her again.
It's hard not to be, like, happy, but, I mean, it's just not the same without her.
Was your mom unconscious in the end, or was she not able to communicate? Because she showed me you having a private moment with her, sitting by her bedside. Is that correct? Please know it is your mom's way of saying to you that everything that you said to her, she did hear, and that nothing was left unsaid. I feel bad saying this to you, but there's nothing like a mom. And I'm very sorry for you that you lost your mom. And that you have to embrace so many things without her.
I've known Corey before her mother passing. She wants to be close with me, but I think she was always afraid to be, that she would upset her mother.
This is about you, but in the same breath, thanking you for everything that you do for Corey. She made me feel like the thing that she loves and admires about you is that you're always encouraging Corey to include and remember her mom. Because you always say, am I overstepping a boundary? I don't want Corey to feel that I'm trying to take the place of her mother.
I say that all the time.
Your mother says it's hard enough that you lost me and that you feel as if you're all alone. Your mom is saying to you, I give you permission to love her as if she was your mom, and not to look at it as anyone trying to replace mom.
Now that I had my reading with Teresa, I'm now gonna try to be more happy and let myself open up to people.
I hope that you leave here today with the gift of knowing how much your mom loves you and how proud she is of you.
I believe Corey needed to hear that it's okay to love me and move forward in life.
When people have a group reading, they sometimes are looking to only connect with one specific loved one.
Hey, Teresa, how
Hi.
Are you?
How are you? Nice
Good.
To
how are
see you?
You. Same here.
But that's not up to me who comes through. That's up to spirit.
Oh, look how hello.
And sometimes a soul will step forward and speak that they weren't even wanting to connect with.
Thank you for having me.
I am not here trying to make you a medium follower or for you to believe in what I do. The only thing that I do ask is that you just embrace the messages from spirit. So, I don't know
See, I want to start with somebody else, but they're not letting me. Who lost the... Did somebody lose the son?
That's my son, yeah.
Yeah.
My name is Camille. I'm from Howard Beach, and my son passed away 20 years ago. My son had leukemia, and when my son passed away, I felt like I had just died. I felt like the whole world just caved in around me and my husband.
Why do they keep telling me to go back years ago? He made me feel like for years you sacrificed your own life or your own happiness or things for you to do for the sake of others. Is that correct?
Yeah.
And he says, and this is what this is about. Did you stop living years ago?
Yeah.
Recently, going through some pictures, seeing myself with my two sons at Christmas time, and how different this Christmas time is, and how difficult it is, and how much I've changed. I don't like it.
Your son says there's somebody else that she'd like to connect with, and he stepped aside. Do you understand that?
My husband?
Mm-hmm.
After my son passed away, 2 years later, my husband passed away. It was like hell on earth. I felt like there was no life left in me.
Did he pass from the chest? Because he's laboring my breathing.
Had a heart attack.
So it was from the chest. As sick as your husband might have been, he said, I always felt that I was gonna make it. He says, but then I got to a point where I just knew that I, no matter what I did, nothing was making me feel better.
There is a point where he wanted to die. After my son passed away, I feel like my husband wanted to be with my son. I felt like I was left with everything to take care of and doing it alone.
Because he said to me, he said, Theresa, it's not that I gave up. He says, trust me. He says, I fought a good fight.
Yeah, but I thought he gave up.
Theresa, he goes, there's a huge difference in giving up and your soul knowing that it is your time. He says, please tell my wife I live to the end of my block of time. I think that it's important that you know that your husband says, I didn't give up.
Yeah, it is important for me.
And he says, and I want you to be able to embrace life with happiness and joy.
Hearing from my husband makes me feel better. Because there were times I felt like I lost a lot of love for him. But I'm realizing tonight how much I did love him. And how much I probably still love him. Now I shouldn't be angry with him.
I feel like my soul was just released. Like I feel this weight has just been lifted.
He's the man I didn't think would come through. After hearing from my husband tonight, I feel like I'm releasing the anger that I had. I'm gonna leave here with my heart a little lighter.